It's been an action-packed week. Here's what's coming up on The Refresh. Both Microsoft and Apple launch exciting new flagship products. Microsoft also reveals Windows 10 Creators Edition. Twitter shuts down Vine. We review the Apple Watch 2. And Bike Lock Maker kicks up a stink. In a big week for computer hardware, both Microsoft and Apple revealed flagship products that will have you salivating. I hope you're sitting tight for the next 90 seconds. Let's start with Microsoft. After a soporific start to their New York event, it continued with the announcement of an update to the Surface Book, which they've called Surface Book i7. It says it's twice as powerful as the previous version, but Intel fans look away, as it will be packing last year's Skylake processors rather than the latest 7th-gen Kaby Lakes. The hybrid laptop also boasts an impressive 16 hours of battery. Then, the big reveal of Surface Studio, Microsoft's first desktop PC. This all-in-one has a 28-inch tilting touchscreen that can be used with a Surface Pen and the Surface Dial, a clever new peripheral which adds another way to interact with the screen. A feature comic book designers and the like will be excited by. Could this be the new iMac killer? The following evening, it was time for Apple to make their move. And make their move they did. After showing off its new integrated TV app, which it claims will change the way we watch TV, the feature that's been rumored for months burst into reality on the new MacBook Pros. The OLED multi-touch bar, aptly called Touch Bar, replaces the function keys and promises to transform the way you work with your apps. The features are too many to mention, so make sure you check the article on the website for a comprehensive list. But arguably the most exciting feature is the Touch ID fingerprint scanner, which allows you to log in securely and make online payments with the press of a finger. Thinner and lighter than previous models, Apple no longer sees the need for a MacBook Air, instead introducing a basic 13-inch MacBook Pro that doesn't come with the Touch Bar as a replacement. None of these items will be cheap though. The Surface Book i7 will set you back nearly $2,000 post-Brexit, while the basic Surface Studio will cost around $2,500, converting from the dollar price of $3,000. If you think that's expensive, Apple will be charging nearly £1,500 for the 13-inch version without all of the goodies, while the top-spec 15-inch version will cost a staggering £2,700. For anyone living outside the UK, prices are still just about affordable for the average stockbroker. Make sure you check out the website for more in-depth coverage of these announcements. Meanwhile, hardware isn't enough for Microsoft as they plan to bring 3D to the world and make us all creators with the Windows 10 update it's named Creators Edition. Fully rolled out next spring, it will feature extensive 3D developments. Among other things, you'll be able to scan a real-life object and turn it into a 3D creation, which can be shared on Facebook or transposed back into the real world through HoloLens. And you can even make objects in Minecraft and turn them into 3D content. The free update will also allow you to stream live gaming from your PC without the need for extra software and give you the ability to create custom tournaments from the arena on Xbox Live. Something which did go under the radar was the partnership it announced with a slew of hardware manufacturers to produce affordable mixed reality headsets that could run in a similar vein to its HoloLens platform. Sandy beaches and cocktails could be coming to a lounge near you very soon, with a full rundown of the updates on our website. In what would have been headline news in any other week, Twitter has ditched its short video sharing platform, Vine. The 6-second loops of mega lols couldn't compete with the likes of Snapchat and Instagram. In reality, the initial creative idea behind the app has largely been corrupted by people recording clips from sporting events and illegally sharing them online. Twitter is reported to be looking for a buyer, but until then it's axed 9% of its workforce and will instead focus on the live streaming app Periscope. Vine itself will be kept online so you can still watch all your favourite shorties if that's your thing. Right, straight back to Apple and their new smartwatch, the Apple Watch 2. Reviewed it this week, here's what tech chap Tom Hunyans had to say about it.
Well, the original Apple Watch felt a bit like a first draft. The Series 2 can be considered a more refined and better executed smartwatch that suddenly makes a whole lot more sense. Now you can go for a run without even needing your iPhone and get accurate distance tracking, or even take the Apple Watch 2 swimming and not have to worry about it becoming damaged. In the end, if you're looking for a smartwatch with some proper fitness credentials, the Apple Watch Series 2 is now a serious contender.
And finally, if you're a bike thief, you'd better go shopping for an inconspicuous gas mask this weekend, because the Skunk Lock is crowdfunding and it hopes to leave bike thieves gagging on their bolt cutters. Break into this lock and you'll be sprayed with an emetic chemical deterrent called Formula D1. Yes, that's real. And it causes shortness of breath, compromises sight, and can even induce vomiting. Apparently this pepper spray-like gas is legal in the majority of US states, but you'll have to check your own local laws if you're thinking of backing this project. Hopefully, having had my bike stolen, this will prevent thieves from sniffing out an opportunity. Right, I'm sure you've heard enough of my voice for this week, but you can join me at the same time next Friday for more.